Is there internet in here? Because I'm...
No, there's not.
There isn't.
No.
I just... Yeah, I keep f***ing up the words.
Okay, it's Q101. I'm Kevin Manno, and this is a real treat. Jet swinging by the studio, stopping in to play a couple songs. Hello, Jet.
Hello.
Good morning.
So you guys aren't even, you're not even like playing a Chicago show. You're just here. You're passing through.
We're just here just for you, man.
I appreciate that.
We decided to have a couple of days off in Chicago rather than sort of sit in the bus.
And was that rather than somewhere average.
Yeah.
So what do you do? What did you do with your time here
we
yesterday?
We ate steak yesterday. Which
yeah,
was
I heard you
good.
Went to the place in the James Hotel, right?
Yeah, it was excellent. I gotta say.
So what else do you do? You ate steak. I want to know
what
Jet
does
in Chicago.
We've been here so many times. I think we just sort of we go. You know what? There's so many good guitar stores here in Chicago as well. That's
yeah,
pretty
we went
fun
down
to check
to
them.
Sort of like an area where there's all German stuff.
And Lincoln Square or something. Lincoln something.
And then, so that was cool because we had like had some sausage, had some beer, and hang out down there. Oh, I didn't know there was a full German area in Chicago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have everything. Did anyone buy anything at the guitar store?
No. Louis was looking, but he didn't make a purchase.
Lou.
I'll buy a guitar. My gift to you. Thanks for coming in. I know the record's been out for a few months now. I think I heard you guys say it was like maybe the most fun you've ever had recording.
Yeah, it was. It was definitely kind of a bit of a laugh, you know. Like we had a lot of fun while we were doing it. It wasn't so serious, you know. Obviously we take the music seriously, but we made sure that the process was fun.
Yeah,
because in the past sometimes the process was a drag, and that's not how you should make music.
Well, it's your third record, and I'm always sort of just curious about a band such as yourself. Get Born was your first record, and that was such a smashing success, and to come out of the gate with that, does that put pressure on for the next one, or just for the future of the band?
Yeah, absolutely it does, you know, but I mean, I guess it's how you deal with that pressure, you know, as part of it, and, you know, yes.
From there, talk about sort of the progression, I guess, from Get Born to Shine On to Shock Rock, like the different mindset behind each album.
A quick snapshot into it. The first one was sort of a lot of just sort of naive, real, you know, naive, but also just real sheer fun and excitement, you know. We were just kids having an absolute ball, you know.
Mm-hmm. And it's almost impossible to recreate that.
Exactly.
Once you do it once.
The second one was a lot more considered and introspective, I guess. And the third one is sort of more closer to the first one. But, you know, you can't help but take on board everything that you've learnt from the previous experiences. So it was, you know, kind of like a bit, you know, somewhere in between, I guess.
Once you sort of get out of LA, get out of the sort of big studio sort of thing and go and record with, like, a really good guy like Frenchie, who we recorded with, like, sort of like a friend as well, mm-hmm. co-produce it and just, you know, just free it up a bit and don't worry so much and,
right.
you know, just enjoy it. So I think that's what, you know, the third one. And we were in Austin.
In Austin?
Yeah.
I was just in Austin a week and a half ago for South by Southwest.
Yeah. Well, it was, I've never been to that.
Ah, it's the best. Oh, to South by Southwest, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the best in Austin. Austin's probably my second favorite city outside of Chicago.
I think it's fantastic. Great yeah. place, you know. I mean, we were there during, like, the hottest months. So it's like, you don't wear a jacket for like 6 months. It's crazy.
I want to know, what's hot to you? Like 25 degrees?
It was because we're on hot. Different. I mean, it was 110 down there.
But, like, but I'm Fahrenheit, you're Celsius, right?
Yeah, I think it was like 40.
For you?
In Celsius.
Okay, yeah. In Celsius.
Which is probably about 110, 111.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
All right, guys, thanks so much for coming in. I do appreciate it. I know there's really no Chicago show, so the fact that you are willing to come in and hang and give Chicago a little mini concert on the airwaves, that's awesome of you. What are you guys going to play?
We're going to do, is it two songs we're going to do?
Yeah, we're going to do 17.
We're going to do 17.
And
that's right. Yeah.
Perfect. And tonight in Kenosha, that's not far from Chicago. If you people can hear my voice right now, our voice is in Kenosha, so it's not that far away. Tonight, the Brat Stop, right? Brat Stop.
Yep.
Is that we'd a sausage say, factory or something?
Yeah, it's a sausage factory.
It's the Brat Stop. I always say
gig.
Brat, and people make fun of me because it's
I say,
Brat.
I say it's
bratwurst.
I say Brat.
I wouldn't say bratwurst.
No,
German.
Americans say Brat.
Brat.
We'll say Brat. And
you would spell Brat,
B-R-A-R-T,
right?
If you were a German
he
person,
would say,
say
he would
sausage.
Say Brat.
I'm going to step out and let you guys finish this conversation.
Bratwurst.
Playing with Crash Kings tonight at the Bratwurst Stop in Kenosha. It's Jet. Thanks, guys, for coming in.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks.
Thank you.